A very good morning to one and all viewers. Myself, Dr. Jayaprakash, AN, Associate Professor, the Department of Rasashastra and Vaishajya Kalpana, Barol Institute of Ayurveda, Barol University, Vadodara, Gujarat, welcomes you all for this today's live webinar. So before commencing any of the program, it's our custom to invoke Lord Almighty to seek his blessings. So here I'm going to pray Lord Shiva to seek his blessings. Mangala Charana Charana. Yasya Ananda Bhavena Mangala Kalama Sambhavite Nasmura Dhamna Siddhara Samyate Na Karuna Bhiksha Sudha Sindhuna भक्तानां प्रभावसंहति जरा रागादि रूपक्षणा शान्तिं यान्ति च यत्रथा कान्तिशये तस्मै परस्मै नमः. Salutation session to Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is considered as Pradhana Vishak, seeking his blessings. With this auspiciousness, let me welcome our renowned speaker, Professor Shashi Kumar Nechal, to this webinar session. I welcome you, sir. I also welcome Dr. Hemantadeep Tushikane, Dean, Principal, Barol Institute of Ayurveda, this session. I also wholeheartedly welcome Dr. Bhagwan Kulkarni, sir, Principal, Barol Institute of Ayurveda, for this session. I welcome all of you. So now to introduce our speaker, Professor Shashi Kumar Nechal, sir. Sir has completed his undergraduation from Vaidyaratnam P.S. Mariyar Ayurveda Medical College, Kottakkal, University of Calicut, and post-graduation from reputed IPGTRA, Jamnagar, Gujarat Ayurveda University. To recall some of his previous experiences, he has worked as a visiting professor at Ayurveda College, Coimbatore. Later, he has worked as professor and head of the department at Shornur, that is Vishnu Ayurveda Medical College. Later on, he worked as a professor and HOD of the department at PNNM Ayurveda Medical College at Thrissur. And he was also a member of GMP Framing Committee of Government of India, AYUSH, and also GMP Framing Committee of Rasaushadhis. Also, he was worked as a member in the Postgraduate Board of Studies, Kerala University of Health and Allied Sciences. Sir has published various papers. Sir has participated, presented, and invited as a guest speaker in more than 50 national and international seminars, symposiums, and conferences. And even he was a delegate to the foreign countries like Japan and Singapore. Sir has authored some of the books Sankalpa, Ayurveda in Cartoon, and Novel Life. So there are many credits to Shashi Kumar, sir. Currently, he is working as a chief physician at Nechal Ayurveda Vaidyashala and Nursing Home at Palakkad. And he is also a chief executive officer at Siddheshwara Drugs, and also mentor and consultant to the International Society of Krishna Consciousness, Govardhan Eco Village, Wada, Maharashtra. And also he has recognized as Ayurveda Guru, Rashtriya Ayurveda Vignana, National Ayurveda Academy, New Delhi. So I feel motivated to introduce you, sir. Today, sir will be speaking on the topic, Role of Rasaushadhis in Pain Management. So now I request Dr. Professor Shashi Kumar Nechal to take over the session. Sir, please. Sir.
आस्तां तावदीयं प्रसूति समये दुर्वारशूलव्यथा नैरुच्यं तनुशोषणं मलमयी शय्या च सांवत्सरी एकस्यामि विना गर्भभारभरणक्लेशस्य यस्य क्षमो धातुं दुष्कृतिमुन्नतोऽपि तनय तस्यै जनन्यै नमः। दिस् इस् ए वर्सेस् फ्रम् द ग्रेट् सेज् शङ्कराचार्य हू इस् मेकिङ्ग् ए डोरेशन् आफ् all the mothers, those who only can tolerate the intense pain during the labor and the postpartum labor and all the troubles going through the consummation period. No sons can pay back for all her trouble. That's why the Shankaracharya, the sage, making his adoration towards the mother. So here he specifies about the shula, the pain. In Ayurveda, the sound pain refers by two words mostly. One is shula. Of course, you have different types of shula mentioned, the term starting from Annadrava shula, Parinama shula, and danda shula, shira shula, so many shulas. Then sometimes there is vedana. So two sounds, vedana and shula. Vedana usually comes agandu, usually, not everywhere. Like trauma, when Sushruta narrates about the causes and features of trauma, bhagna, there he says, vividha vedana pradurbhavaha. So vedana is there. Two types of words are we can found in Ayurvedic classes to refer pain, intense pain. And the vedana you can consider as two, and physical and mental, sharirija and manasaja. And rightly telling, in Ayurveda, Ayurvedic classics are not at all in favor to give directly painkillers. Ayurveda is managing the pain. Of course, any pain Ayurveda is managing well with so many tools. That is how Ayurveda treating the diseases also. I used to say my students, one example, how Ayurveda is treating and body. So it is just like playing a chess. You can equate with the playing of chess. In chess, we are what we are doing. We are doing so many movements, and at last we are giving a check to the queen. So that's where Ayurveda is managing the patients. So something in first phases I'm going to describe some basic thoughts about the pain and management of pain and methods of pain in referred in Ayurveda. Then one by one disease I will refer, and there I will give the method of approach and the medicines involved in that method. So that is what I want to say specifically when I am starting this session. Ayurveda has no simple medicine, just like painkillers, diclofenic sodium, to give generally to all pain. In fact, we have managed all the pain, but different methods and different drugs in different diseases to arrest the pain. And what is the nidanas of the pain? Shula is classified into 8, like Vata Shula, Pitta Shula, Kapha Shula, Samsargaja Shula, Sannipata Shula, and Amaja Shula. These are the way Shula is classified. But if you are thinking the pain, all diseases are connected with some sort of main mental pain or physical pain. So these all diseases have some fraction of pain. That's why people are coming to us for the treatment. People used to say every clinical setting that, sir, please control my pain. That is enough. I cannot bear with the pain. And I will continue your medicine how much you want to cure the disease. Before I need the management of pain. Rightly, Ayurveda says, Chikilsa Ruk Pratikriya. Half of the treatment should be concerned to control the pain. Pain is not bearable for the patient. So that should be controlled. If you cannot effectively control the pain, means it's not a treatment. Of course, that is our target. But method of management of pain is different. Of course, in our some of the medicines, we are using opium, we are using bhang, that is cannabis, and we are using ativisha, and valsanabha, gunja, and karaskara, all these drugs, potent drugs, which can stop pain. It's a painkiller. But Ayurveda is not in favor to advise this medicine without any logic. There is some logic. So what is the logic that we have to find out? Apart from the Shula, this 8 Shula, we have Abhigadaja Shula, Shula. Trauma, after attacking the trauma, pain will pain will come. So how to deal with that pain? Then we have Garbha Shula and Makkala Shula. Makkala means Garbhaja and Sutika, two types of Shula is coming. And we can, another class, we can get Agni Vrana, Agni Dagdha Shula. In Agni Dagdha Vrana, we get pain, severe pain. And Vishaja, in stings and some snake bite or some bites, pain will be there, intense pain will be there. That is, you can classify it as Sthavara and Jangama. In Sthavara Vishas also, you will get pain. And in Jangama Vishas also, you will get pain. How to control this pain, that you have to study. And the new class is not new class, it is there in our classic, iatrogenic, because after the surgery, after making an incision to the body, after making the management of fracture, immobilization, by these methods, you are making some pain to the body. So how to control this type of pain? This is called generally nowadays iatrogenic. Iatro means physician, genic means the physician made pain. So how to control this class? That's also we have to address carefully. Then only we can develop a pain management system in Ayurveda. And in Chakradatta, one Chikilsa Sutra is mentioned to manage the Shula, not Shula. Vamanam, Lenghanam, Sveda, Pachanam, Phalavartaya, Charachurnam, Nidagdhika, Shasyate Shula Shantaye. These are the Chikilsa Sutra to manage Shula. In this Shula, we are getting Annaja Shula, that means Parinama Shula, Annadrava Shula, all these Shulas. But the Agantu pain, like Abhigata pain, is different. There is no Ama. Here it is Ama. The Ama makes making intense pain. As far as the Samprapti Ghatakas are concerned, Dosham, Dushyam, Amam, Agni, Srotasa, these are the Samprapti Ghataka. Among this Samprapti Ghataka, Ama is the basic cause of pain. So the trial for Ayurveda, the target of Ayurveda is here is to remove the Ama. If you are removing Ama properly, you can control the pain. So to remove Ama, we have different tools, different upakramas, we have different drugs, we have depending upon the types of Ama. Ama is two ways the sound Ama is representing in the classic. One is Amashyekadam Dushtam, Ushmana Atpa Belatvena, Dhadu Madhyama Pajitam, Dushtam Amashyekadam, Rasam Amam Prachachade. Indigestion, due to indigestion, some indigested materials are developing in the stomach, and that's make problem and number of issues. That's Ama. another ama is ajirnam tu kapha. Then the ama is classified into vatas vishtabdham, pittad vidagdham, and another ama, rasashesha ama is there. Vishuchika is that. Suchipiriva gatrani tudyadiri vishuchika. Suchipiriva gatrani, that much intense pain. And vilambiga is there. The great example of vishuchika, now we are getting in cancer. In cancer, the ama, if you are searching the basic cause of, basic cause, participated in that process of disease, if you analyze the ama, that is nothing but the vishuchika ama. That is why it's making too much intense pain. So at that time, the body will be more toxic. Visha shabda is came there. There we have to use, they have visha is there, so they have to use agata. Means another visha you have to use, stavara visha you have to use. There comes the rasa shastra medicines. Then vilambiga is there. Sometime this ama will stick to the walls of the srotas and it will not come to outside. So it will make severe pain to the body, severe disease to the body. I will give an example for this one. Is I think this sometime the urinary calculus, it may come from the kidney, but it will not enter into the bladder. In between the ureter, it will stick. And that type of ama, we can consider as a vilambiga. So here we have to use some medicine, which is very good for apana vaigunya and for vilambiga. And if you are using this type of medicine there, with a mutrashmari shamana drug, you can easily control that type of pain. So these are the basic that we have to remember when you are dealing a patient and planning for the subsiding of pain in a patient as far as Ayurveda is concerned. And what are the tools that we are using to control the pain? That is Sveda. Okay, Sveda is the best tool to control the pain. We know that is so many references are there. And in Charaka and in Vagbhada, the Anga Marda Prashamana Gana Dashemani, Vedana Sthapana Dashemani, all these things are mentioned. These drugs also you can use internally, and for Sveda also you can use the same thing. And in the different types of Sveda we are using. And in that we are coming Lepa, some Lepas we are using. For example, in headache, we can use some lepa which is working as a counter irritant. For example, if you take some shunti powder and mix with some warm water, add some rice in that one and apply locally, that will make contra irritations in this site, and it will reduce the pain. That's where lepa will work. So many lepas we have, and different lepa we have in different aspects, in different diseases, we can use. That we will discuss later. Then Upanaha. Upanaha, you know, for so many swelling area, for example, Kartuka Shirshaka, Sandhi Shula, we can use Upanaha very well. Another thing is Sega. Sega is the best form of method to arrest the pain. In Sega, you can use Taila and Kashaya and Kshirapaka, Dhanyamla. Dashamula Kshirapaka is the best Seka Dravya for Inamavata. Internally, if you, first of all, you have to correct the Samavasta, then you have to give this one, it will give wonders. Dhanyamla is the best media for Seka in any Vata Jashula. Mainly, the pain is developing when the track of Vata is blocked with some other thing, maybe Pitta, maybe Ama, maybe Kapha, maybe Dhatus. So there what you have to do, you have to give Anulomana to the Vata. Anulomana for Anulomana, Sveda and is the best one. Sveka is the best one. So there Dhanyamla is the best remedy. Dhanyamla is the best remedy for all Vata Vaisheshyam, for Sveda. And Taila So many taila we have, and different aspect we can use different tailas. Then Nali Sveda we can use. Then Avagaham we can use. Avagaham is very good for in renal colic pain. After applying some Dhanantara or Sahachara Taila for half 15 minutes, just boil the water with so many Vatahara leaves and go for Avagaha. It will give, it will help to diminish the renal colic pain with some internal medicine. That we will discuss later on. Now we are one by one, we are discussing about the Kriya Kramas. Then for low back pain, you can use Avagaha in the same way. And also for the pain in the piles and the sinus and the Bhakantara, you can use so many medicines, put in the water and boil the water and go for Avagaha. For example, Palandu, cut the Palandu into small pieces and put some salt and put in the, and boil the water. Which water you should use for Avagaha? That is helpful in controlling the pain of piles. It's very good, effective one. Then, Nidra is another tool. Usually, if somebody is affected with a headache, what they are telling, oh, I want to sleep. If I sleep 15 minutes, my headache will vanish. In Ayurveda, for the Rasasheshama, Nidra is considered as the best remedy. Rasasheshama even develop the Hrid Shula. For such Shula, Nidra is the one remedy that you have to remember. You have to use all these things campaign form. Then only you can control the pain effectively. Then Nasya is very good. You know, different type of Nasya we can use in headache. If headache is in Sama Avastha, better to go for Dhuma rather than Nasya. Suppose sinusitis you got. If it is blocked and the doctor is suggested for removing the sinus, pus and everything outside to wash the sinus, like that, then at that time we can consider Samavastha. There you can go Dhuma procedure. Dhuma is very effective. There you can use Kasa Dhuma, the Kasa Dhuma Varti. The Dhuma mentioned in the Kasa, it's Manashila and Trikatu, grinded with milk and make a Varti and dry it, and that is that you can use. You can add even Gugulu to that one, and that's really a very good Varti to fumigate in sinusitis. So Nasya also you can use. Nasya, so many Nasyas are mentioned. In chronic headache, the Bhringaraja Swarasa, mixed with some little bit goat milk and go for Nasya. That is a very good instant pain reliever. When you are doing so, should filter the media very well. There should not be any particle when you are going for Nasya. That is very much important that you have to take care. Then Kabala is there. Kabala means, so Dandashula, Kabala is the best one. In gingivitis, it's the best remedy. Kabala means, for example, take 1 spoon of tila, black tila, 1 piece of ginger, dried ginger, little bit salt, crush it and grind with takra, buttermilk. Boil it and go for Kabala. It will give the reduction of the swelling of the gums instantly and the pain will relieve. Thumam I told, then Basti is also giving very good results. In low back ache, usually we are getting. Now, suppose it's a Vata, Kevala Vata Prakopa, the basic cause is Kevala Vata Prakopa. How the clinically is presenting now, one patient will come and he will say, see, yes, sir, I just yesterday came from Gulf and I have to sit 4 hours continuously in the flight. And after getting down the airport, again, I have to sit 2 hours for the checkup and came outside. So when I reach my home, my hip is painful. If you touch there, there will not be that much swelling, but the foot will be with swelling. In that condition, go for some fermentation with Dhanyamala and give one Sneha Basti, like with Sahajarati Tailam or Dhanandarab Tailam. Instant relief you will get. You will get 70% result from that. And another form we are getting now, slip disc. In where we can diagnose is Shopa, Vata Shopha. Suppose you touch there, you can see that it is a swelling. That is just a aired balloon. And see your pain is there. There you can use a vasti. Take 1 liter dhanyamla and 1 glass of gomutra in that one. And add some Vaishanara Churna, like 10 grams or 20 grams Vaishanara Churna in that one. Then give a vasti. That will give intense pain reliever in that condition. Condition is very much important. You have to find out the condition, and according to the condition, you have to use. And if you are diagnosing with modern diagnosis and you are using Ayurvedic medicine, means it will not be possible. You can diagnose in modern way, but you have to interpret in Ayurvedic way. Then you can effectively use our tools. I think so. That's my experience. Then rectamosha, of course, if there is an abscess which is in here or in the backside, jaloka is the best tool. Even in swollen piles, you can put jaloka to reduce the pain. Here, that the pressure of the swelling is stimulating the nerve and developing the pain. So if you can relieve the swelling by any means, pain will reduce. That is the way. And after the jaloka ucharana or siraveda, something like that, you can go for lepa. And in varicose vein, siraveda is the best tool to relieve the pain. And these are some examples. And pachana drugs. Pachana drugs is very good. Gandhaka is very, very good pachana. Gandhaka, if you are mixing with Shangha Basma, means that's a very good pachana. Add some more Navasara in that one. How it will be? There are Shastra people can understand very well. Navasadara. Navasadara in Jasaratna Samhita says it can digest properly the meat. Indigested meat. So the combination of Gandhaka Basma, Shangha Basma and Navasadara is a wonderful pachana drug. The pachana drug will change according to the status of the patient, according to the status of the involved doshas, according to the climatic condition, according to the age that you know. And then Agni Karma, of course, nowadays many people are using Agni Karma as an efficient tool to control the pain, especially carpal tunnel syndrome. It's a very good example. And cones is very good example. And charam. Charam is very good. There's a spadika charam. If you mix the basma of spadika charam, just fry the kangshi and make with basma. And that basma, you put little bit in the dental caries, you will get instant pain relief. That these are the something that we can thought the basic thing. Which are the common drugs that we are using to pain relief for? Dashamula is the best pain reliever, of course, in complicated conditions of the disease, just like cancer, that is vata rakta, just like very chronic shirashula. Dashamula is the best one internally and externally. Externally in the form of dhara, so many way. Dashamula Kshiradhara is the best remedy for any sort of Vata Kshirashula. Vata Kshirashula nowadays is present like in the form of migraine. And Ahifenam, you know, opium. And Vijaya, that Bhang. Bhang nowadays profusely used to control the pain in cancer. We are also using same thing. Our Lakshmi Vilasarasa is a very good combination with the seeds of the Bhang, the cannabis. And that's giving intense relief in headache. And same thing we can use. So many combinations are available. So many products are available in Ayurveda with cannabis, like Panchasara Gulam. Panchasara Gulam. Madana Kamaishwari Leham. Usually in the text, and everybody is familiar with this text to improve the aphrodisiac effect of the body. In fact, we can use this same thing as a very good painkiller. Suppose you are a practitioner of bone reduction. You are an orthopedician. First 3 days there will be intense pain and the patient cannot sleep. So give 2-3 PM and look. He will sleep in the night beautifully. third day the swelling will come down and the wound will heal. So third word onwards, there is no need of any painkiller. Our medicine, our kwatha and salaki, like things will be effective. So first 2 days, people will think about the modern diclofenac sodium or some sleeping doses, compost like that. But in spite of that, we can use Madara Kameshwari, Panjasara Gulam, all these things. That's where you can manage. But it should be reduced. Logically, if you some yuktiyavishameva matraya bhachidam shvilam amritam bhavati priya, these slogans we have to remember. Then Ativisha is a very good ama pachana drug. So ama is the basic cause of the pain, I told you earlier. So so many medicines we have under the Bhairavar, so many Surya Prabhavati for the pain of tonsillitis and laryngitis in acute condition, highly inflamed condition. When you are thinking that this need a steroid with an antibiotic, at that time if you give Surya Prabhavati with ginger juice and honey twice a day for 3 days, it will give the desirable result. And Vatsanabha, Gunja is there, Gunja Garbharasa is there, and Gunja contains so many oils are there in Ayurveda. So that is for external application, it's giving very good. And Karpura is there of a camphor, you know, our wicks and everything is contained camphor only. And Karaskara is very good pain reliever. And if there is a wound, profuse infected wound with pain, prepare Panchavalka Kashayam with one part of Karaskara Tuk. Or take some neem leaves and some Haridra and some Durva and one portion Karaskara Tuk. Make a Kashayam or Shirapakam according to the conditions. Then go for Dhara. You will get intense pain relief. Then Gloriosa has a very good effect of painkiller. Nowadays in the Ayurvedic industry, some products are coming in the market with the extract of the seed of Gloriosa with Sallagi combination. That's giving very good antispasmodic action. So in low backache, so many such conditions, this is giving wonderful remedy. So that is in general, it's over. Now I am talking about the individual diseases. So starting from the head, we can describe, I think, some sort of approach should be there. No, that's why I selected that way. So Shiroroga, that's also a very big chapter. So I am going a little bit speed, hurry. So for the sake of easy understanding, I'm using modern terms, but the modern term should be understood in Ayurveda way, then only successfully you can treat. So sinusitis, in sinusitis condition, that is a Kabaja Shirashula, in the Shirashula angle, you can also think that is an Andarvidhriti sometime. So in Ayurveda, you can use different diagnostic names in different avastha of the diseases. That much discretionary power is already given to the physician. Then only you can effectively manage the disease. So as I told you earlier, in sinusitis, in profuse infection condition, better to use dhuma dravyas. I told you very good combination of dhuma, manashila, don't use haritala, haritala is very dangerous there. Can use it, but with caution, better to work in the safe mode. So manashila, trikatu, little bit gugulu, grind with milk and make a varti and store in your pharmacy. So take one varti, apply some ghee and inhale the fume, intense result you will get. Then if you are giving some internal medicine like Pathyakshadatriyadi Kashayam, it's the best Kashayam. But when you are giving Pathyakshadatriyadi Kashayam, many people will feel some discomfort in the stomach. For that, you have to add some Madhura Dravya in that one, some Gudda as a Prakshepa or honey as a Prakshepa. If there is an indigestion, ama is there, then better to give with the Gudda with some Pippali powder. This Kashayam you can use any any sort of disease related to the head and neck. And I will give you a combination, a ENT antibiotic, to understand very, very well. I am using this terminology. Gandhaka Basma or Shuddha Gandhaka. Shuddha Gandhaka means it should be purified with four medias. That's milk and Kumari Sarasa, ginger juice and lemon juice. That is, you will get very good Gandhaka Basma after powdering. This will not make any side effects in the prescribed dose. Mix with Rasa Sindoora to augment the effect of Gandhaka Basma. Add some Shangha Basma. Shangha is a Shola Prashamana. It will correct the stomach also. So that's a plus point. So make a combination. 20 milli, 25 milligram of Rasa Sindoora and 100 milligram of Gandhaka Basma, 100 milligram of Shangha Basma. A combination. Mix with 10 drops of ginger juice and honey. Take it by daily. This is a very wonderful antibiotic which you can use in sinusitis, in otitis, in laryngitis, in gingivitis, every itis related to the ENT. You can use this one. In eye problem also you can use. When you are using eye problem, make use of Tripala as a media. And so in sinusitis, if you are giving this one, with this one, and first phase you can cover with the Dhoma, second phase go for any nasya like a Kshirabala, Dashapaka Kshirabala or Shatapaka Kshirabala or Anutaila. You can use this thing. Or you can use Murivanna. In Kerala, we are using Murivanna too, and we are using Kottanjukkadi Tailam, which is a reference from Sahasra Yoga. That's also giving very good results for sinusitis. In later stage, after the Ama, that means Nirama stage, you can use. In that way, the sinusitis you can manage very well, the pain you can manage very well. And I told you the Dandashula you can manage very well. I told you, I already described a combination for Kabbalah. And here also to arrest the infection, you can use this combination. When one person is coming by after plucking the the teeth, he's complaining that intense pain. And sometimes he may say that I cannot take diclofenac sodium or some sort of allopathic painkillers because my stomach will ruin. So in that condition, you try this one. You will get very good result. That's my experience. And in otitis also, you can use this thing. And Karpasasti is the best drug mentioned in the classics to tackle the earache. So you can use Karpasasthyadi oil. If there is, as I told you earlier, if there is Amavasta, profuse pus, better not to use any oil. Go for fumigation process. Same combination, Manashila combination, that will give very good result. And in a year, when you are pouring the oil, before pouring to the oil, just heat it so that you can remove if there is any organisms infected to the oil, like fungus, something. If you are keeping that oil in a bottle in your pharmacy, sometimes there may be some infections of fungus or something like that. To means you have to heat it, then only you have to pour. Then it won't give any problem. Then tonsillitis. In tonsillitis, I gave Surya Prabha reference and some gargling. And here, Tankana Madhu is the best one. Purify Tankana, just fry Tankana, that's the purification. Mix with honey and you can paint it internally, the tonsils. It gives sudden relief, the pain. Swelling will reduce and pain will reduce. And here you can use ginger juice and tulsi juice and honey for gargling. That's a good, very good remedy to arrest the pain. And another method in Kerala we are using, we call it Tala. Tala means mix some powder with some juices and put in here in the Begma for 1 hour. So when it's dry, the pain will relieve. That is we found when we are getting the Shobha in this area. Neck pain, where you can say Shobha, Vata Shobha. So if you apply this one, this pain will relieve. Even in the low back, sometimes you can see if you trace that Shobha will be starting from this area and slowly is coming to there. There you have to put this one. This Tala. Here we are using Kachuradi Churna or Rasnadi Churna with Jambira Sarasa. Jambira Sarasa, it's very good. Put here this will give very good result. And another Suryavarta is there, no? In Suryavarta, it's a Pitta Prakopa. So any Tiktarasa Dravya go for Tala. Means make a kalka of Nimba or Karavelaka Patra. Crush it and make very good space and put it here for 1 hour. Then take bath early in the morning and give some sweet jalebi. Patyashada Tedika Shayam. And sorry. And nasyam with even plain water with sugar. It's a very good treatment for to arrest Suryavarta. And nowadays you are getting many this migraine. Migraine is nothing but little bit unmada. Shiroroga connected with unmada. So the kashaya, like a Mahakalyana kashaya, if you mix with Patyashatanga, that's a wonderful remedy for migraine. Continue that medicine for 2 months. And some Jyotishmati products contain some Jyotishmati, that you can give. For example, our Smriti Sagara Rasa, which contains the oil of this one, give specific days, 14 days like that with milk at the bedtime, because bedtime is a very good time for the drug to administer for the head diseases. Give that one. That will give wonderful remedy. You can cure after giving these 2 months with the proper digestion and correct the digestion. If proper agri is there, switch over to Ghrida, like Kalyana Ghrida, Panchagavya Ghrida, like that. Complete cure is possible. People are telling the migraine is not curable. Migraine is curable if you are following this way. And the patient should follow Patyakrama. Indigestion should not be there. Tension should not be there. Like that. Then herpes. In herpes, sometimes it may affect the trigeminal nerve or sometimes this area. Severe pain. Even modern medical professionals cannot control pain in that way. Here, for all neuralgic pain, Manasamitra Vataka is the best one. If you properly prepared Manasamitra Vataka is there. Give one pill with milk at bedtime or any of one day. Apply locally the Shatapaka or Dashapaka, Kshirabala, and give the treatment of Luta Visha. Effectively, you can control herpes. You can cure herpes. And the millets we called tina here, which we are feeding to the birds, that is in turn if you give with mixing with the boiling with the milk, that's very good. And grind that one with milk and apply locally, that's also help to reduce the pain. And you know the Vandaga, the Vanda roxburghii, which found on the trees of the imili, that means the tamarindus, it's a very good medicine for herpes. Crush it one leaf with milk and give, or half of the leaf, if it's a very big one. That will be very intense result. And that's trigeminal and the good result for herpes. Herpes, any part of the body, you can manage in this way. Then angina. Angina, pain you can control, no? If you can give this Dadima Swarasa with the Saindhava. Very good. And you have to give this Swarnagarbha Potali, Hemagarbha Potali, 4 hourly with ginger juice and honey. And take Shatapaka Chirabala, heat it and apply externally. Give little bit fermentation. That's where you can control the pain of angina. That is, I have some experience in this way. And the Parshashula, give medicine sometime, Parshashula too. Parshashula or Pushkaramula is the best one. Make the Parshashula you can found in the TB cases, in some chronic cough cases, and in the angina. And there is a Kashayam in Sahasra Yoga mentioned, Adalodakam Kodutuva Putri Chunda Jiragam, Kodashari Vayambu Nallurinyadu Chukkumai. Hindu Pittukudikilo, Chumayum, Kurayum, Pinna, Padapum, Parsha Pedi, all this is Malayalam. So refer that one, vasha, vasadika shayam. That is a very good remedy for this one. And stomach pain. Stomach pain and parinama shulya, annadravasa, ulcer pain. Kantaloha bhasma. That's the best one. Kantaloha bhasma with ginger juice and honey. Properly prepared kandaloha basma. If test is mentioned 10 puta, go for 20 puta. If text is mentioned 4 medias and advice to give any one of them, don't listen that. Go for 4 media for the purification and prepare very good kandaloha basma. That is giving very good result in parinama shula. And gotandi basma is very good to control the acidity of the stomach. And there is so many things. Amalaka khanda, khanda malaki is very good. Saptasaram kashayam, mentioned in Sahasra Yoga, is very good to arrest the shula. Saptasaram kashayam. In this way, you treat 2 months or 3 months to heal the ulcer. After that, you have to give any grita like Indukanta grita or Mahakalyana grita or Dadimadi grita like that. That is the way how we are treating. Then, renal colic. How you can arrest renal colic? A renal colic, you know, Shweta Parpadi, Chara Parpadi, same thing. Mix it little bit. Suppose you are taking 400 mg Chara Parpadi. Mix with 20 milligram of Rasa Sindura. And take in plain soda. Soda, you know, drinking soda, carbonated water. Yeah. Mix it and take internally thrice a day. Then go for avagaha after applying the dhanantara. Give internally sahacharati tailam, 10 drops with the satahuati kashayam. Satahua, prepare kashayam out of satahua, you know satahua. Then add 10 drops of the sahacharya, the tailam, then give internally. I told you early, it's vilambiga, sometime. Then this will help, and avagaha sveta. This way effectively we can control the pain, and up to 12 mm of stone we can easily remove. But it should take at least some time, 3 months. But the pain we can arrest easily. I'm talking only about the pain killing, not the curing of the disease now. Then renal colic, UTI. UTI, Gokshurati Gukulu, Chandra Prabhavati, and tender coconut water with the Chara Parpati. Very good. Then, okay, the menstrual pain. Menstrual pain is nothing but our Rekta Gulma. In that, this Kandaloha Basma is with the ginger juice and honey. Very good. Dhanuntaran Kutika with the Jiraka water, Jiraka Kashayam. How to prepare jiraka kashayam? Take 2 teaspoons of cumin seed, fry it, and pour 1 glass of water, reduce it to 1/4. That is the way. Filter it and mix with dhanantara gutika and take. Usually the young people, means the teenage people, are complaining that, no, it's gulma only. So if you are taking 1 pill, you will get intense pain relief. Don't take any painkillers, modern painkillers. Or if it is profuse, go for this one, the Kantaloha Basma. Kantaloha Basma is very good. And some fermentation. With that fermentation also, you can control the menstrual pain. And sciatica. Sciatica, Shephalika is the best one. You know, Shephalika Sattva. And Balakoranda Mooladi Kashayam, mentioned in Aarogyakal Padrumam.
And plain
Rasasinduram with the Shankha Basmam, with the ginger juice and honey, once in a day. So 2 times Balakoranda Mooladi Kashayam, 2 times Shephalika Sattvam, and even Leshuna Kshiram is also very good pain reliever in sciatica. Then what else? Piles, I told you. Piles, I will give you a combination. In piles, to cure the piles, to reduce the pain, Chandra Prabhavati is very good with milk. And a combination of Rasa Aushadhi, Rasa Sinduram 25 mg, Swarnavangam 100 mg and 100 mg Kachapa Asti Basma. Kachapa, you know, tortoise.
Kachapa Asti Basma.
Then a combination of this, give it with ginger juice and honey twice in a day in intense pain. It's giving very good result. And Dusparshagadi Kashayam. Dusparshagena Villuena Yavanya Nagarenava Patha Handi Arshasam Rujam. This combination also very good for piles, and apamarga lata, collect it fresh and grind it. Made the quantity just like namalaki. Mix it with takra and take. It's very good remedy. Then colic pain and meal. Low backache. Any swelling, any joint diseases.
In joint diseases, sir, to
control the pain, you have to reduce the swelling. Swelling reduction you can do by lepa and any seka. Lepa, I will tell you a lepa. Take the fruit of datura and cut the upper part, the calyx part, so and remove the seed inside. It will be like a pot. Fill it with black tila or sarsapa. You know where tila should be taken, where should sarsapa should be taken. Depending upon its property. Cover it with the leaf of guluchi. Bind it with thread and boil in the dhanyamla or milk. After boiling, grind it well and mix with some castor oil or some butter.
This is a very good plaster.
Very good plaster. Apply in the cloth and apply locally in the back side continuously for 3 days. That's a very good pain relief, very good plaster to apply. Even Kroshtukashisha you can apply in the big joint inflammation. In the spondylosis you can use. Any site you can use. But when you are using continuously 3 days, 4 days, sometimes for some people, some rashes may develop some that site. So you can use any plain coconut oil or some Nalpamaradi Kera to remove that one. And another thing is our now pain is coming, carpal tunnel syndrome. Carpal tunnel syndrome, we are dealing with agri karma. That sudden relief you will get. Then you have to give kashayam. That's only our adhivatam, vadarakta only. So give some a combination of kashayam like varnadi and dasnadi kashayam with the kaishwarya gugulu or amrita gugulu. And a combination, rasa sanduram with kasisa basma with pravala basma. Rasa sanduram 25 mg, 100 mg, kasisa basma 100 mg, pravala basma, combine together and give with ginger juice and honey once in a day. Then sani shobha shamana avaleha like dashamula haritagi or gomutra haritagi at bedtime. Apply some oil like prabhanchana tailam or for Sahajaradi Thailam, go for fermentation. Usually what I am telling, no? I am telling applying Prabhanjana Thailam here in the, here, this part, and put in the warm water for some time and do the exercise to give the elasticity to the tendon. Then doing so for it in 1 month, it will slowly, slowly reduce and it will vanish. In that water, to give more effect, you can put some Vatahara drugs. Then go for that one. In that way you can. And tennis elbow, same combination because it's a Vavar Vatarakta Adivada only, same internal medicine. And you can use some other fermentation method here. Cut one lemon. And in that cut area, you smear with the powdered salt. And make a potli, small potli with a towel, with cotton towel. Like bind it. So you will get a small potli. Then heat it in a plate, warm plate, hot plate. Then do the kiri here, little bit for 15 minutes. when the heat is subsiding, again you have to heat it and do like that. That will give pain relief, instant pain relief. For curing, you have to give internal medicine. Then what is the other thing? Carpal tunnel syndrome. Okay, now my time is over. This much I have to say. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for patient hearing. And if there is any query, I'm very happy to answer for you. And again, I will tell you, Ayurveda has no way to arrest the pain directly. Ayurveda is not advising to arrest the pain directly with the medicine. So many procedures, so many methods. Correct the ama, correct the swelling. That is the way how to arrest the pain. And observation the pain is a key tool to understand the intensity of the disease. How you can assess that the pain is reducing. This is the only way. How a patient will say, now my pain is subsided, pain is relieved. That's where only you can assess the condition of the patient. So with that, I'm finishing my talk. Thank you. Thank you very much. Namaste.
Thank you very much, sir, for deliberating various treatment modalities.
Okay.
And various internal and external administration in the management of pain. Sir, here we have questions. During conclusion, you have told there is no direct management of pain. But still, there are some questions. Let me ask. Sir, in acute management of traumatic injuries, acute pain management in traumatic injuries, any of the medicine you can use?
Yes, yes. In traumatic injuries, Dhara is the best one. Seika is the best one. You can go for the Dhara of Tilataila, ghee and honey. Take 500 milliliter Tilataila, add 2 spoons of ghee and 1 spoon honey. Heat it and go for Dhara continuously for 1 hour by little bit heating. That's a very good pain reliever. It's not simply pain reliever. It's a good remedy to heal the wound, to heal the bone. And also, you can go for Dashamula Kshira Dhara Seka. Bala Kshira Dhara, also very good. Lepa of Satathauta Grita is very good. Lap of Gantha Taila, not Ganthaka Taila, Gantha Taila. Application of Gantha Taila is very good. And if the trauma is near to the this nails, the pain will be more, no? So at that time, mix the breast milk with butter, if it's available, and cover it. That's very good pain reliever. This type, Marma treatment is, that is separate section. Marma treatment is there. Okay.
Pardon?
It's not audible.
The choice of medicine in neurological pain.
Choice of medicine?
In neurological pain, sir. Neurological pains.
Neurological means you specify the disease.
Ha, sir. Any type of neurological pains.
It's a very vast subject. So neurological pain, there is not common approach. Any neurological, you specify the disease, then that disease, the medicine and approach will change.
Okay, sir, see now we have in modern medicine, medicines like diclofenac, tramadol and all. Sir, any drug can be correlated so that we can get immediate relief?
No. It cannot correlate like that. That's early itself I cleared. We can manage the pain, but in different neurological condition, different modalities will be there, different medicine will be there. For example, trigeminal neuralgia. In trigeminal neuralgia, Shiradhara with Dashamula Shiradhara is very good to control the pain. Patyakshatatriyati Kashayam is very good to relieve the swelling from there. And external application, there's a Kshirabala, Dashapaka Kshirabala, Shatapaka Kshirabala is good. Also, you have to give Manasamitra Vataka. Manasamitra Vataka will reduce the neurological pain there. In that way, you can control the trigeminal neuralgia if it is not so chronic. That's where you can control. That's why for each and every neurological disease, our approach and medicine will be different.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, one more question. Role of Visha and Upavisha Dravyas in the management of pain, sir?
I told now Valsanabha about Valsanabha, I told, and Gunja, I told, and I told now.
Yes, sir.
That's how yeah. For to arrest any other question?
So, sir, can we develop any injectables?
Any
injectables in Ayurveda, sir?
Of course,
we can develop. We have to,
because the concept is there with us. Suchi ka apharana rasa is there. Suchi mukha rasa is there. Name mentioned by. Many texts, Sarangadhara Samhita, Baishajiratna, Rasaratna Samuchaya. So these are the basic concepts that we found out that the drug which can induce through the bloodstream, it will work wonders in the body. So depending upon that concept, we can change all our combinations into injectables. I think I was, when I started my practice 26 years ago, I was using injectables. One pharmacy from Madhya Pradesh, I think. One pharmacy was marketing in Ayurvedic injectables. I was using that one. Later on, I don't know why it is vanished.
But whether it was effective, sir?
Very effective. Also, I tried that samples in albino rats to find out its absorbing methodology. And it's found it's not making any abscess, nothing. It's very good because it's water media. It's highly absorbable. Our arkas can be given like that.
Okay, sir. Sir, but now can we recommend or can we initiate the same injectables?
Of course, we have to. But okay, the investment will be very huge, no? We have to prepare the injectables and we have to fill it in a very zero bacterium. In that circumstances, we have to make the ampules so that we can use it. Try with some medicine. Dashamula, you can start with Dashamula injection.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. So that's all questions, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I take this opportunity to thank you on behalf of Parul Institute of Ayurveda and Parul Institute of Ayurveda and Research. I wholeheartedly thank you, sir, for sharing your knowledge and also enlightening our viewers by telling the knowledge about how to manage the various painful conditions in various diseases. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
And also, I take this opportunity to thank our dean, Dr. Hemant D. Toshikane, sir, and also our beloved principal, Dr. Bhagwan Kulkarni, sir, for giving opportunity to coordinate this session. Also, I thank all our department staff for their support in the going of this webinar. And special thanks to Dr. Navodaya Raju for his uninterrupted support, technical support in smooth going of this webinar. Before closing this webinar, let me announce tomorrow's topic, that is Rasa-Shuddhis in the Management of Neurological Disorders by Dr. Pradeep Agnihotri. So, first, all the viewers, stay tuned to both the Parul Institutes for further webinars. Thank you, one and all.